So you have a job interview coming up right away and you're wondering what you can do to quickly prepare for this job interview so that you don't fall flat on your face. In this video, I'm gonna share with you 5 best last minute job interview prep tips that you can use right now and take with you to your next interview. And to help you get ready for the most commonly asked interview questions, make sure you download your free copy of the interview guide cheat sheet. I'll place a link for you down below. If we've never met before, I'm Heather Austin from ProfessorAustin.com and The Career Club on Facebook. And on this channel, I help professionals just like you build your personal brand so that you can land your dream job and grow in a field you love. So if you're new to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below and don't forget to hit the bell notification so you're notified when I conduct a live training or publish a new video every week. You might have a job interview scheduled today, tomorrow, or even in the next 30 minutes, and you still want to make a good first impression so that you can land your ideal job offer. Well, I have some good news for you, but I also have some not so good news for you. Let's start with the not so good news. The best time to start preparing for any job interview is as soon as it's scheduled. So ideally, you will have been preparing and studying for your interview days beforehand. The good news is that it's not too late and you've come to the right place, even if you only have a few minutes to spare. I'm gonna show you exactly what you need to do so that you can use your time wisely before now and your interview. Let's jump into my top 5 tips to get you ready for your interview fast. Tip number 1, dress to impress. Make sure you dress appropriately for your interview. This is one of the most important things you can do before your interview and it will help you give a good first impression. And when you're deciding what to wear to a job interview, use the step up method. This is where you're going to dress one step above what others wear in a typical workday in that company. And keep in mind the same principles apply if you have a video interview. And if you have plenty of time to choose your outfit before your job interview, make sure you take a look at this video right here where you'll learn exactly what to wear to a job interview. I'll also link it for you down below. Now, if you've already left your home and you don't have time to change, don't worry because step number 2 you can do on the go, and that is to get ready to make a good first impression. Making a good first impression in an interview makes a huge difference, and this can set the tone for if your interview will go well or if your interview won't go so well. I want you to visualize in your mind how you're going to introduce yourself to your interviewer so that you can solidify that first impression. So choose your first few words to say to your interviewer. It could be something like, "Hello, it's nice to meet you. My name is Heather Austin." Or, "Hello, I'm Heather Austin. I'm so excited to be here today." Be ready to greet your interviewer with a smile and a handshake, or an elbow bump, a firm nod of your head, or even a bow. And if you're nervous, practice your introduction on the way to the interview. Or if you have time, practice it in the mirror at home so that you can work out all the kinks. Pre-planning your greeting will help you better make a good first impression. It will also help your interview run smoothly. And if you have a few extra minutes before your interview, make sure you take a look at this video right here where you'll learn exactly how to make a proper introduction in an interview. I'll place a link for you down below as well. Step number 3, review the job posting. This is also a step you can do on the go. Before you go into the interview, make sure you pull up the job posting and review it thoroughly. Make sure you know exactly what they're looking for in their ideal candidate and what things you're going to focus on and how you're going to answer questions that might come your way. Think about some of the biggest projects you've worked on or some of your greatest accomplishments. Think of career stories that you can tell them that show your qualifications and why you are the best fit for the position. Reviewing the job posting will give you a lot of clues into what they're really looking for. Step number 4, research the company. This is also something else that can be done on the go. And keep in mind, one of the biggest red flags to a recruiter is when they interview someone that doesn't know much about the company. They expect that if you really want the job, you've done your research. You know what their mission is. You know what their core values are. You know what the company stands for and why they do what they're doing. So take a minute really quickly to look at the company's website. Also, follow all of their social media accounts and find out what their latest post was. What are things that they're talking about right now, and what are some of the biggest pain points that they have right now? You can also try Googling the company to find out anywhere else that they are mentioned in the news and online. If you don't already understand what the company does, it's critical that you take just a few minutes to learn some of the basic functions of the company before you go into the interview. Step number 5, be ready to ask your own questions. As you're doing last minute research, take out your phone or a piece of paper and jot down some questions you might want to ask the company. At the end of the interview or during your interview, your interviewer might say, "Do you have any questions for me?" One of the last things you want to say is, "I don't have any questions for you. You've answered them all." You need to go into the interview with some solid questions that you can ask them. You can ask questions about the company. You can ask questions about the position. You can even ask questions about the team you might be working on. Remember, a job interview goes two ways. You're also interviewing them to find out if this position is a good fit for you. So treat your interview like a two-sided conversation. Now, the plus side to this is that it's going to take the pressure off of you just a little bit, and it puts it back on them. And if you want a detailed list of questions that you can ask in your next interview, make sure you take a look at this video right here. I'll place a link for you down below. And don't forget to grab your free interview guide cheat sheet. It will help you answer the most commonly asked interview questions. I'll place a link for you down below as well. And if you like this video, be sure to hit the thumbs up button down below. Be sure to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this, and I will see you next time.